Yes.
Action.
Hallelujah. Good afternoon. We're here to speak to you about Jesus, and the word says, and God says, that we are to have the mind of Christ and to shine your light into our lives, Lord Jesus. That's what we ask, and says at 2 Peter 1:19. And recognize any darkness in our lives is from God's enemy. Jesus, in your heart brings joy. And in your workplace, home, activities, health, finances, Psalm 91 for protection, Psalm 23, it says, through the valley of death, well, Jesus there with you when things are not going well for you. So our Lord Jesus Christ desires that we ask him into our hearts.
Yes.
Yield our lives, surrender our lives, obey God's word. And Jesus is the same today, yesterday and forever. I'd like to tell you some of the benefit God gives us when we are members of his family and we are alive with Christ. He dwells in our hearts and we are in unity with him. He says, abide in me and I in you, together with the Heavenly Father and the Holy Spirit. And then we can then live an anointed life full of the power, love, sound, steadfast, strong bond given by the Holy Spirit. And we are free of condemnation. I'm going to list some things that comes into our lives when Jesus comes into our life, and that is the first one. We're not guilty. And the first text taught in Sydney was Psalm 116:12, which says, what shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits towards me? So I'm going to read from the National Prayer Notes, which our leader, Pastor Paul, gave me. And it says, the first Christian service on Australian soil was conducted under a tree on a grassy hill. It was described as an impressive occasion. Careful preparations were made. The converts were being ordered to appear as clean as circumstances will admit, and no man to be absent on any account. The guard was to be changed earlier than usual, so as to give those who had been relieved time to cleanse themselves before church, and the church drum was to beat at 10 o'clock. And the service took place on the 3rd of February, 1788. The Parramatta is known as the cradle of the nation. The fleet has been in Sydney Cove the previous Sunday, the 27th of January, but no service was held until some semblance of order had been created on shore. Now, Richard Johnson, Reverend Richard Johnson, was a chaplain to the colony in New South Wales, would have been impressed by the nature of the occasion and would have chosen his text and prepared his sermon with care. The content of the sermon has not survived, but the text was Psalm 116, verse 12. What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? This verse is set in a context which was appropriate for the occasion, as it reflects the experience of someone who has undergone severe and repeated sufferings, but has survived to give thanks to God for his safe deliverance. Johnson would have drawn his congregation's attention to the way in which the experience of those who had arrived in the first fleet was parallel to the experience of the psalmist, and then gone on to urge them to respond to God's benefits in the way suggested. God's benefits in the way suggested. By verse 13, I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. The sense of relief at having finally landed in an area at least looking comparatively promising. Has given Johnson the opportunity to speak to both convicts and soldiers in a meaningful way, and this would account for the manner in which the congregation responded. The service was well received, and reports state that the behaviour of both the troops and convicts was attentive. 2 weeks later, on February the 17th, Johnson celebrated the first communion in the colony. The service was held in Lieutenant Ralph Clark's tent, borrowed for the occasion. The event was recorded by Clark in his journal. I will keep this table also as long as I live, for it is the first table the Lord's Supper was eaten from in this country. And now I'd like to tell you some of the benefits, a beautiful benefit of being in God's family, as it were, up to two. One was no condemnation. Two is, we are fathered by him, and he loves everyone equally. We are being healed by the stripes of Jesus Christ, Isaiah 53:5. Three, we are in the Lord, and we read our Bible. and then do what God says from the Bible. 4, we are the salt of the earth. 5, we are the bride of Christ. 6, we are established by grace. 7, we are drawn near to our Heavenly Father by the blood of Christ. And when we repent, He washes our sins away, and God forgives the sins. 8, we are disciples of Christ. 9, we are delivered from Satan's darkness. 10, we are protected by angels. 11, we are redeemed by the blood of Christ. 12, we are blessed with spiritual blessings. And 13, we are complete in Christ. So invite Jesus into your heart today. And remember that Jesus' name is a mighty weapon put in our hands in our prayers. And I say another 6 blessing over you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And the Lord give you peace. And we thank you and praise you, God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.